One of the most amazing things about Jesus Christ is that you can experience Him as real right now while you're alive. And that's how you can know 100% that He's risen from the dead, because He sent His Holy Spirit, which can speak and which gives you divine feelings. Those people who are born again know what I'm talking about. If you've never experienced Jesus, you won't have a clue. But if you have met Jesus Christ and you experience how He floods you with His divine Spirit, and you feel His love, His joy, His lightness, and His light at the same time, it's a divine feeling you cannot just brush off, because you know it is God Almighty. And the only access you have to this Holy Spirit is through faith in Jesus Christ. If you seek Him with all your heart in prayer and cry out and call out to His name, if you repent of your sins and diligently seek Him, He will come to you and flood you with Himself. And then you'll know that God came to you. And then you have to stay in His presence, which is the hard part. You have to keep yourself prayed up, and you have to speak to Him, and He will guide you. He will guide you both by senses. He gives you divine senses, and He will both speak to you, because as Apostle Paul said, that it is God who makes in you to will and to do His good pleasure. God gives you the mind of Christ. You just know that you know that you know you must do something, or you feel a divine want from God to do certain things rightly, righteous and holy, or you just feel a divine call from God to do a certain thing, and it's a righteous, holy feeling of His Holy Spirit. And when God speaks to you, the way how you know that it is God is because you can ask Him, and Holy Spirit, which is in you, He will either confirm it to you by His warmth and by His peace, or He will not. If it's not, if the thought which came to you is not from Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit which is in you, He'll give you an alert feeling. The only thing you have to make sure is that your heart is a receptive mode, that your heart is not stony, because if you have a stony heart, then the stony heart doesn't feel the grace of God. It's not receptive. It cannot be sensitive to Holy Spirit. So we have to make daily maintenance, a lot of time in prayer, to maintain a sensitive heart to the Holy Spirit and to abide in His love and His grace. Jesus said that if you keep My commandments, you will abide in My love, just as I have kept My Father's commandments and abide in His love. So if you seek Jesus with all your heart, He will give you both senses to will and to do His good pleasure, and He will speak to you, and He will confirm it to you through His Holy Spirit. And you will also have the mind of Christ. You'll have understanding what to do. Jesus Christ asked from us two things: holiness and fruitfulness in the Spirit. He asked from us fruit of the Spirit. And secondly, He asked from us fruit of souls. He wants us to be fishers of men, and He wants us to bring other people out of slavery to Satan and to the spirit of the air, unto obedience to Jesus, so they can become children of God. And Jesus Christ wants us to be disciples and make other disciples, and He will use you as He sees fit. To be a fisher of men, He will call you to street preach, He will call you to make YouTube videos, He will call you to give out gospel tracts and just to speak to people in houses or wherever you meet them. He uses anything. He knows you better than you know yourself, and He knows where it's best you're applied, and He'll also confirm it to you with His joy, what He sees suits you best and where you are most fruitful, so you'll know. And there is measure of knowledge of Jesus Christ and measure of growing in grace. You have to grow in grace, because Jesus Christ said that this is the condemnation, that light came into the world, but men loved darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil. You see, people who met Jesus, who experienced Him, who experienced this divine presence, the feeling, the sense of Holy Spirit, either He came on them or they got born again. You get born again only when you are really obedient to Jesus. He comes to dwell in you in His fullness. If they left Him, or they loved darkness more than Him, they loved this world, or they loved the evil spirit which is behind this world, that's why they choose Him. They disobey Jesus, and that's the condemnation. Now you have to all the time abide in His love, all the time abide in His grace and grow in it. Not just abide, but grow in it. Grow in the knowledge of Jesus. Knowledge of Jesus is not just knowing about Him or just knowing His ways. Knowledge of Jesus is abiding in Him, growing more to abide more in Him, so He grows in you more. And that's how it is. And that's the kingdom of God. And Jesus is our teacher. What does He teach us? He teaches us the kingdom of God. He teaches us His ways. He teaches us to submit to His guidance every day in different situations, and He leads us through those situations, and He teaches us through what we suffer, and also He teaches us when we do good. He shows us, He gives us His joy and His peace, and we grow in it, we grow in His knowledge. So are you growing in the knowledge of Jesus Christ, or you don't even follow Him, or you have never met Him, or you met Him and left Him? What about you? Seek Him, because it's only His approval we're after. Only He knows, are you there or not? Are you on that road He prepared for you uniquely or not? Seek approval of God only. May Jesus bless you.